This is David, you're watching BTech, and welcome to another video. This one is sponsored by Direct Mobiles. For the best mobile deals, check out directmobiles.co.uk. There's been plenty of talk and coverage about the new wave of flagship devices that we're seeing from the different manufacturers, including Samsung, Huawei, and Sony. These new handsets take things up a level in so many different areas, and you just have to love the speed at which the tech develops. But with such impressive devices grabbing all the headlines, what about the new wave of mid-range phones? When it comes to Sony, the Xperia 10 Mark II seems to be a huge upgrade from the Xperia 10 and the Xperia 10 Plus that came before it. But it wasn't just a size difference, they were also running two different Qualcomm chipsets. Launched alongside the Xperia 1, these were among the first phones to have the 21:9 screen aspect ratio. For the first time in a while, we had something a little bit different. I actually really liked both the Xperia 10 and the Xperia 10 Plus, but I did say in my review for those devices that they seemed to be a little bit underpowered and a little bit slow. The chipset, in my opinion, was just not really up to it. What's more, the plastic construction that just had a matte finish to the back made it feel a little bit cheaper than the price tag suggested. But Xperia 10 Mark II changes things. First of all, there is just one model. It has a much more solid construction with a 6-inch OLED display and that 21:9 aspect ratio, also protected by Gorilla Glass 6. What's more, we get the same level of water and dust resistance as the flagship Xperia 1 Mark II, with an IP65/68 rating. Immediately, this seems like a major upgrade from the LCD screen and plastic construction that we saw last year, and it will give it a much more premium look and feel. Xperia 10 Mark II will run the Snapdragon 665, which hopefully will give it a much smoother and speedier performance than the last generation. These improvements alone really do make this a far more attractive proposition. This could be a really good phone, depending on how much it is. I always think to myself that the manufacturers should stagger their mid-range and flagship smartphone releases because the flagship just always seems to overshadow the mid-range, and in this case, especially so. But again, depending on the price, I think this phone could be a big hit. It has premium materials with premium components in the fact that it's got an OLED screen. The Snapdragon 665 should be able to handle the demands of even the heaviest user and still be relatively power efficient. The battery is where last year's models got quite a bit of criticism. Even their flagship Xperia 1 had a relatively small battery in comparison to its rivals. This time, however, they've gone for a 3600 milliamp hour unit. So not a massive battery, but a decent enough size for this mid-ranger. This, together with the bang-up-to-date Android 10 software, should give the Xperia 10 Mark II a good battery life. I did want to mention the software actually because I really like how the software skin in Sony phones has developed over time. With both the Xperia 10 and the Xperia 1, you've got a really clean and responsive user interface, very close to stock Android, with touches here and there that reminded you that it's a Sony handset. The SideSense feature, which we first saw on the Xperia XZ3, which would let you call up a little side menu by double tapping on the edge of the screen. It started working off fairly well with the XZ3, but it got much better over time, and now it's a really useful feature in the Xperia 10 and Xperia 1. This will surely see a return, and hopefully be even more refined and responsive than ever. The software also takes advantage of the extra tool display and offers a multi-window, which allows you to have two screens or apps open at the same time. But this year, they've added the ability to switch between the last used and recommended apps whilst you have multi-window open. Another surprisingly good feature that you got with the Xperia 10 Mark 1 is the quality of the audio when listening through headphones, and especially through wired headphones. As with the more expensive Xperia 1 Mark 2, the Xperia 10 Mark 2 will come with a headphone jack. When I reviewed the Xperia 10 Mark 1, I was really surprised at how good the sound quality was with these relatively affordable devices. There is a really noticeable difference, and it really puts many far more expensive flagship phones to shame. Expect a similar performance, although ideally I would love to see an improved performance from Xperia 10 Mark 2. Sony say that it will have high resolution audio and high resolution wireless audio. Expect this phone to again be put in the 1000 plus flagship phones to shame with its audio quality. Of course, there's the cameras, and on Xperia 10, there wasn't really anything to write home about. I'm hoping for a big improvement in camera quality this time around. It is a triple camera system with the same focal length as the premium Xperia 1 Mark II, but this one has one 12 megapixel and two 8 megapixel sensors. There's a 16mm ultra wide angle, a 26mm normal, and a 52mm telephoto lens. But this time, Sony say that they've improved the color science and have made it very simple to take great photos. They also mention presets for food, portraits, and also an improved night mode. Sony plan to deliver this phone at a similar price to the Xperia 10, then I'm not too optimistic at this point about the camera being that much better than the previous generation, because they've improved so much elsewhere in the device, in particularly in its construction. So it's quite hard to see where they could squeeze in a decent camera for the price. Of course, I hope that I'm totally wrong about the camera and that it will impress. But I think that the fact that they're not really making too much fuss about the specs for the camera in the Mark II kind of says it all. But from what I can see, that's okay, because this clearly is a big improvement over last year overall. But again, it all comes down to that most important specification of all, and that's the price. If they can bring it in below £400, then I think we got a deal. This will put it in direct competition with the forthcoming Pixel 4a, which we've just seen massive leaks and a hands-on video about. The device looks identical to the early renders that we did a few weeks back. Google really are the worst at keeping these secrets, which is kind of worrying for a company that knows absolutely everything about us, don't you think? Anyway, what do you guys think about the Xperia 10 Mark II? It looks a lot more attractive to me than the Xperia 10 did. Let me know what you think and drop me a comment below. I'm sure it won't be too much longer before we get a review unit in, as well as the Xperia 1 Mark II. So if you want to know more about these phones and you want to see us give them the proper once over, then make sure you're subscribed and hit that notification bell so you know every time we post a video. And when you're ready to buy your next phone, the best place to look is the Direct Mobile's website. You can compare all of the available deals with all of the networks right there on the one website. And they have over 24 years of award-winning customer service, so you're in great hands. The link is in the description below, or you can search directmobiles.co.uk. And if you're looking for the best tech and accessories, make sure you check out the BTEX Amazon shop. All of our favorite tech and recommendations are there. And if you choose to buy through the BTEX Amazon shop, a small portion comes towards the channel. If you've already bought something through there, thank you so much. We really do appreciate it. And if you haven't, well, the link's in the description below. Okay, that's it from me. Thanks for watching. More BTEX tomorrow. You can follow me on social media. I'm David, this is BTEX.